Hi, I'm Kelly Holmes with MyPrintResource.com, and we're here with Udi Ariely of EFI. Thank you for joining me, Udi.
Hi, Kelly. Thank you for inviting me.
Absolutely. Udi, I heard a rumor that you're up for the PIA Lewis Memorial Lifetime Achievement Award. Is that correct?
Well, I was nominated, if that's what you're asking. The judges did not make up their mind yet, so we don't know who is the winner. But in my opinion, I'm already a winner. Because as you know, for many years, I'm working with the industry, trying to bring new theories, new products, new ideas. And I didn't know if people appreciate it or not. So when I was nominated, I was really surprised and humbled to read all the nomination letters that came for many experts in the industry, consultants, editors of newspapers in the industry, customers, and it was really nice and surprising to me to hear that they appreciate what I do for the industry, that they understand what I do for the industry, and it really helps them, so it's great. So, regardless if I'll finally win it or not, in my opinion, I'm already a winner. How many people know what other people think about them before they die? So I don't need someone to read something on my grave. I already know what people think about me. So,
well, let's hope we don't have to do that anytime.
Yeah, so. I hope so too, but you never know. But it's great.
Udi, as the industry consolidates and print jobs become shorter run, we're seeing lower prices and all kinds of pressure in the printing industry. Can you still make money with a $200 digital print job?
Kelly, that's an excellent question. And the short answer is yes, you can. But you have to change how you do business, how you manage your company, how you manage your production. You can't use the old processes anymore. And it's not even enough, let's say, to buy a digital engine. You need a full new workflow and new way of running your business so you can become profitable. You have to automate everything. You have to take touch point outs, etc. So it's a big subject. Maybe we'll talk about it later. I don't know what you're going to ask me, but it is a big subject, but a lot can be done. A lot of customers are already doing it and seeing the correct results. So the answer is yes, you can make money.
Why is EFI's digital workflow different?
There are many reasons. First of all, EFI as a company took upon itself as a goal to really bring innovation to the printing industry and to solve the question that you asked me before. Because the printing industry is competing against the internet and the e-readers and the iPads and many other digital devices. And to be able to do it, you have to invent new processes, new way of doing business, new way of making money. And EFI as a company took it upon itself as a goal to develop this automatic workflow. So the issue is that EFI have developed a totally automatic workflow from submission from a customer through the website, it's digital storefront in our language, to managing the job and planning the job with pace, and then scheduling it automatically with Printflow, submitting it into Fiery or Fiery Central. It depends if you are using Fiery-driven engines or non Fiery-driven engines. We have answers for both. And of course, at the end, the job comes at the printer. The whole idea is that the whole process is totally automatic and you can run job totally lights out operation, totally touchless. And all of this, the EFI workflow connects also to all our own equipment like Vutex or Rastec or Jetrion, etc. So the whole idea is we understand that you cannot make money if you continue like the old ways with many employees, many touch points. You have to automate all of it so you can make money. It has to be fast, it has to be accurate, it has to be repeatable. So only in that way you really can make money. And the workflow is not enough that you just say, I'm creating a workflow in integrating few products, but it has to be intelligent, what we call smart software. A lot of people know PrimFlow dynamic scheduling that is intelligent and probably the first intelligent software in the printing industry that can make decisions for you. The whole workflow has to be like this. So decisions are made automatically. Now, some other companies have tried to create workflows, but what they have done, they've said, okay, we just take a web submission tool and try to submit it to the engine. But they are taking out all the processes that are necessary to run your business correctly out because it was too complex and too much work and too many employees. They didn't know what to do. So what they did, they just took it out. That's not the answer. The answer is like we did. We still leave it in, but we automated it. We put intelligence into it. We put rules into it. We put automation into it to create a totally automatic workflow. And I think that this is the beginning of a new generation of software. I'm sure we'll see much more in it in the future and more development, at least from the EFI side, to make it better, more automatic, better decision making, etc. And that's really the only way to make money. You cannot make money on a $200 job if even two people need to touch it. Forget if five or seven people need to touch it.
Okay. Well, let's switch gears for just a minute. And I understand that you develop and teach the theory, a theory of global optimization. Do you think that that's still relevant today?
Not only that it's relevant, it's more relevant than ever before. And all the time I get people that are coming to the booth or coming to Connect or talking to me wherever opportunity they have, and that they thank me for TGO because it is so important to have the right theory behind the product. That's another main difference between our workflow, not just the automation, and not just that we totally take touch points out, but it has this TGO theory behind it that allow us to manage the business or teach the customer how to manage their business so much better by managing their constraints, by optimizing their throughput, optimizing their production, minimizing their waste, etc., etc. TGO is a large theory. I'm teaching it for many years, and every year that I'm teaching it, more and more people are coming to listen, and more people deploying it and in their business and writing me letters and emails. So it's very gratifying to see that the hard work is paying off, and EFI and myself are really helping the industry.
Okay. Can you tell me what the theory is?
The theory is that you have to look at the company from a global view, and you should look at what's good for the company, not necessarily what's good for customer A or customer B or cost center A or cost center B, but what's good for the company so the company can make money. And the way to do it is by identify your constraints at all time, by maximizing your throughput, by minimizing your make ready time, or as we call it, switch over time, always between two jobs, you have a switchover time and a make ready time. Mm-hmm. So the more that you can group similar jobs together, even in the digital world, jobs that need the same colors or the same type of paper or the same type, does it need stapling or does it need folding or does it need punching? Putting it together in groups of jobs and saving make readies, like this you can increase your capacity actually without buying new equipment. So the whole idea is to concentrate on throughput and on the global view of the company and make all the decision, not according to job costing, but according to how do you increase throughput and what's good from a global view of the company. Of course, that's a very, very short description of a very complicated subject.
Mm. Well, as we've been publishing the show daily here at Graph Expo, I think there's two buzzwords that keep coming up in conversation after conversation after conversation, and those are integration and automation. What do you think about that?
So again, there is a big hype about the subject, and integration by itself doesn't do much, because it just, you can have two people that talk to each other, and they both can hear and they both can speak, but if they don't speak the same language, it doesn't mean much. Mm-hmm. Or if they cannot interpret the language correctly. So two machines that integrate together, actually instead of helping, they're creating more chaos. From the, I was involved with JDF from the beginning, and I'm all for JDF, but JDF by itself is not enough. You need additional tools on top of a JDF, on top of integration, to make sense out of it. So for example, in EFI's workflow, we are using JDF and we are using integration, but we're using it with smart software that can make decisions for you. I'll give you an example. We will transmit the XML file to an engine, for example, with instruction at the right time, at the right second, and not just creating a queue of XML because they're all supposed to go to this equipment. Now, it just creates chaos. When do you do each one of them? Who is going to choose and to say, what do I do first, second, and third? So the operator suddenly has 50 XML files in front of him. Which one is the one that's supposed to set the machine at this second? So integration is good, it's important. We can't survive without it, but without automatic scheduling, without Fiery, without Fiery Central, without all RMIS like Pace and Primflow, that all come together to work together as one workflow with automation, with intelligence, taking advantage of the integration, that's where you get the benefits. So integration by itself, I'm not impressed, and I know many people are trying to do it. It's just a language, it's just a way of communicating to each other, but unless you do something with it, it doesn't mean much. So if you do integration right with the software like EFI is building, that's a huge thing. If not, it's just a hype, doesn't mean much.
Well said.
Thank you, Kelly. I hope that in a short time it was understood what I said.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for joining me today. I appreciate it. It's always good to spend time with you.
Thank you for inviting me, and we are here to educate the industry and to improve the industry, because all of us in this industry, we love this industry. Mm-hmm. And I just want to tell you a little story, if you don't mind. Mm-hmm. My grandfather that started in this business in the early 1900, everyone used to say that when he was working in his own printing company, was the first printing company in Israel. He was singing all the time. He was so happy to work. And in the printing industry in the last few years, we actually lost the singing. I don't see anyone singing. But I think that with what the message that I just gave now, if people will investigate it and understand it better, I think EFI is bringing the singing back, and I myself helping to bring the singing back to the printing industry.
I hope so.
I hope so too.